I'm joined today by David and Faye to talk about the program happening here at the library on Tuesday, October 2nd at 7 o'clock. The name of the program is Reinventing Power, America's Renewable Energy Boom. Faye, David, thank you so much for joining us here today.
My pleasure.
My pleasure.
Faye, can you introduce yourself and just help me understand who you are? You know, we know each other a bit, but you know, what brings you here today? And tell me a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, my name is Faye Strigler. I've lived in Quincy for over 30 years, and I've been a member of Quincy Climate Action Network for the 6 years that it's existed. And I'm trying to participate in changing our economy into a green one, because we need to do that to deal with climate change. The thing about this film is, I think right now people are focused on politics, and this film is a look at a different part of America, which is the trend toward renewable energy in this country, which is creating lots of jobs for people and doing wonderful things for us.
It's a lot of exciting possibilities and things that are opening up. David, let's hear a little bit about yourself. How did you get involved? Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I've been involved since Quincy Climate Action Network originally came together in 2012. We saw a need for a local organization that would promote renewable energy and energy efficiency among residents, city government, businesses, and the state government, and we've been operating in all those areas and have a number of significant accomplishments, which you can find at our website, quincycan.org. Just to mention a couple of the most prominent, we brought the Solarize Massachusetts program to Quincy, which resulted in more than 100 solar roofs on local businesses and houses. And we successfully encouraged the mayor to hire an energy manager who's doing wonderful work making city buildings more efficient and getting the city involved in renewable energy, including a lot of solar on the roofs of Quincy schools.
That is really exciting that we're getting that in Quincy. Faye, I know earlier you were telling me about how there was a mayor's conference or a gathering of mayors and some other municipal efforts that were exciting you. Do you want to tell me again, remind me of exactly the details about that?
Okay. The film talks about some of the several things that are changing the economy to a green one. What I wanted to explain is that these are not isolated incidents, and this U.S. Conference of Mayors that took place in Boston a few weeks ago, maybe a month ago, did a survey of the 158 cities in the country, and what they found was that 57% of participating cities are planning some kind of climate action next year. 60% have launched or are expanding climate policy. Have done that in the last year. 95% of those 158 cities have experienced climate change impacts like droughts, wildfires, coastal flooding, and extreme storms. That's
huge.
We
can certainly speak about coastal floodings here in Quincy. We know a thing or two about that.
Absolutely. 65% of those cities said they use low carbon sources for municipal operations. Eight cities in this country already have 100% renewable energy, and 27 cities cover 30% or more of their needs with renewables, which I think is huge. 60% of cities have clean vehicle programs,
They go over all these numbers in the movie, or these are numbers that you pulled from the survey?
Yeah. Yes. I'm just trying to explain that this is more than just what you find in the movie, that this is a real trend in the whole country. A movement, exactly.
That's really exciting.
Yeah.
So I know that, there's obviously, I'm sure we could talk about numbers. There's a lot of really encouraging numbers. There's a lot of hope to be found there, which is what I always appreciate. It's possible to really feel depressed when we think about issues with the climate, and we feel every year is warmer than the last, and every storm is more violent and destructive than the last. It feels like, maybe that's not exactly true, but sometimes it feels that way. But my understanding is this movie and the conversation that we're going to have with Deb, the state interim director of the Sierra Club, who has history with wind turbines, can actually talk about some really positive experiences that people have had with the movement and how the movement has really improved people's lives. And I wonder if you want to just say a couple things that, you know, people will learn about more in the movie, but to really excite people, because I get over, like, sometimes I hear the numbers and I just start feeling, geez, I'm getting, like, assaulted by this rain of numbers. But there's lives that are at stake here.
The movie tells an inspiring story of transformation of people's lives, of individual people, families, communities, all resulting from the switchover from fossil fuel-based electricity to solar and wind. Mm-hmm. There's a coal miner laid off from a dying industry who finds cleaner, safer work in the solar industry. There's a story of Block Island close by here that formerly got its electricity from a polluting, very noisy set of diesel generators that were not entirely reliable, so there were brownouts in this tourist community, and now they get all their power from five offshore wind turbines, the first offshore wind facility in the United States, soon to be eclipsed by much larger wind farms that are coming in off the coast of Massachusetts and Rhode Island, the first installment of the Massachusetts offshore wind installation is going to have more than 100 huge turbines generating electricity for us.
It's really exciting. The film is about 50 minutes long, I think. And afterwards, we're going to have a conversation with Deb. Maybe you can say a couple words about how you met Deb and why you're interested in hearing from her.
We've been working with the Sierra Club on state-level issues. We've been working together to lobby state legislators on various matters that are before the legislature, including last year's omnibus energy bill. And this film and Deb's participation will result from further, as part of a further collaboration that we decided to embark on.
That's great. I'm really looking forward to it. So now we're actually going to be able to share a little trailer with the film for everyone. And I look forward to everyone then joining us to watch the entire film and then engage in further conversation. Again, this is happening on Tuesday evening, October 2nd, starting at 7 o'clock in the evening.
I've been farming corn, soybeans, and wheat all my life. Used to farm some cabbage and potatoes, but no, I never thought I'd be farming wind.
In 2016, wind energy technicians was the fastest growing job in the United States. Now I think we've actually been surpassed in 2017 by solar technicians.
If someone would have told me in high school, like, yeah, you're gonna find a job in renewable, and like, you're gonna like it. I'm kind of like, hippies, you know?
What's exciting about solar is how quickly the industry is growing.
We can use printing-based technologies to produce a complete solar cell. We'll be able to make it cheaper, better, faster.
After I lost my job in automotive, I actually listened to some of my coworkers' advice to look into wind turbines. You know, it was a new up-and-coming thing, and my circumstances aren't rare. People are going through the same struggle. They worked in automotive, trying to find a new niche, you know, trying to do something different. And so a lot of reinvention going on.
We're up on Garfield Ridge. This is the area that we're hoping to get some turbines at. There's a good number of us that, you know, want to push for renewables because we're thinking about our children and our grandchildren already.
Block Island was a very unique sort of test case for offshore wind.
I really felt how great if the littlest town and the littlest state could be leading the country in renewables.
The introduction of those elegant sculptural symbols of a better future are exactly what Block Island is about and should be about.
We talked about the three green dreams, which is solar to capture the sun's energy, battery storage to hold it so we can use it anytime we want, 24 hours a day. They use that energy stored to power our lives.
It doesn't take a genius to recognize green energy can bring back American industry in ways we haven't even dreamed of yet, because it requires rebuilding everything. The energy solutions are here, and if we build them, it means jobs, right? It means prosperity.